Hi, wrestling fans, and welcome to a special edition of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. I'm Brian Matthews. We're going to be telling you a lot of great things that's coming up on this hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, a lot of great things happening in the area, and we're going to fill you in on all that. Some things you haven't even seen before also today, and here to fill you in on all this with me, unfortunately, is the Louisville Slugger, Jim Cornette.
Oh, shut up, idiot. I'm going to save your career. That's right, because Smoky Mountain Wrestling is making news all over the place. As a matter of fact, the first series of big events in 1994 for Smoky Mountain Wrestling has been announced. It's Golden Week 94, March 10th through 19th. It's all going to take place in the major cities all across the Smoky Mountain Wrestling area, and it's going to be kicked off on Thursday night, March the 10th, at the Cobb County Civic Center in Marietta, Georgia, with, unfortunately, whoop-de-doo, the Armstrong Family Reunion. But it's going to be a big week, and a lot of news taking place there with Golden Week 94. Also on today's program, Tammy Fitch and the Dirty White Girl finally wrestled. That's right, White Girl finally got her match with Tammy Fitch, and we're going to see tape of that today. But it didn't end like everybody thought it was going to. And then, of course, our main focus, our main thrust today is going to be Sunday Bloody Sunday, because for the people watching on WKCH TV 43 in Knoxville, that's this afternoon at the Civic Coliseum in Knoxville, Tennessee, and we're going to examine and focus on all the situations and all the issues going on the Sunday Bloody Sunday card and see exactly what everybody is doing at Sunday Bloody Sunday.
And you know, Jim, also today on the show is the Bullet. He's going to be here today.
Live?
Live.
Not on tape?
No.
You didn't tell me that.
Right here.
Listen, I don't want that idiot coming in here and beating me up when I've only got you to protect me, you big fat lummox. You tell me before he gets here, because I'm not going to be here when it happens. You understand that?
All right, we'll do that.
All right, very good. And now, one of the matches on the Sunday Bloody Sunday card, like I said, this afternoon, Sunday, February 13th in Knoxville, is going to be Tracy Smothers and Chris Candido in the War Between the States. And if you think it's going to be a war, brother, stay tuned for this piece of videotape. Last week, Tracy Smothers cost Chris Candido the Beat the Champ TV title, but Candido in the process nearly broke Tracy Smothers' neck. Take a look at this.
Robbie Eagle has got some good insurance, because this Candido is really taking him to town. A couple of shots by Candido.
Set up in the corner on the turnbuckle.
Robbie Eagle looks almost helpless.
Yeah, he looks like he's groggy, Dutch.
Well, he's going.
He really doesn't know exactly where he is at the moment.
He's going for the suicide plex.
Here comes. Whoa,
wait a minute. Oh! Wait
Eagle's
a minute.
He's going to cover him.
Wait a minute!
We got a new champion.
No, this is going to be the biggest upset.
And new Smoky Mountain Wrestling Beat the Champ TV champion, Robbie Eagle.
That's the biggest upset ever. It's called Love Wrestling.
Look at Tracy Smothers. You said something about Tammy Fitch a while ago, and now Tracy Smothers doing the same thing, interfering in a match.
Candido, you said it was all right earlier when Candido came out to cool him off with that water, Dutch. I think Tracy was just paying him back a little
bit. Wait a minute. Candido's calling him in the ring.
And here
he comes.
Goes.
Smothers. And Smothers is unloading on Candido.
And they're trading right hands. That one, Smothers blocked. Look at those chops. Down goes Candido.
Well, it's the North versus the South right here. Big flying elbow, and Candido may get beat twice tonight.
Well, here's Smothers now up under the top rope, and Candido staggering around. Oh, he got a right hand. He got Smothers right into the midsection with that one.
Oh, wait a
minute.
He's
got a pile driver. A pile driver. Candido pile drived him. Dutch.
He's hurt.
We haven't seen a pile driver in what, years now?
Oh, man, he's hurt now.
Here comes the Dirty White Boy, and there goes Candido. We'll be back, fans, right after this.
February 13th, Sunday Bloody Sunday at the Knoxville Civic Coliseum. They're calling it the War Between the States. The Suicide Blonde and Tracy Smothers. Well, Tracy, it's not a war between the states for the North and South, because we're neighbors. Everybody knows you're really Vito Marinaro. You're really from Schuylkill, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Pennsylvania. We're supposed to be friends. But you see, you got deported from the North. Sent down here to the South to be around people that are just as dumb, stupid, and ugly as you are. So now you want to take it out on me. Well, Tracy, I beat you for the TV title. I dropped you on your head and cost you the Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Championship at Christmas Chaos. I've embarrassed you time and time again. And February 13th, Sunday Bloody Sunday at the Knoxville Coliseum, I'm going to do it again.
War Between the States, February 13th, Bloody Sunday in Knoxville, Tennessee on a Sunday afternoon. Chris Candido, you are the lyingest, cheatinest, little no-good punk. I mean, this guy is annoying. He's cocky. He's not cocky. He's not conceited. He is convinced. You put down the South and you put down me. Yeah, I'm a country bumpkin and I'm a hillbilly. And I want to show you what this hillbilly can do. I'm a rebel and I'm darn proud of it. So that's what you don't know about. People from the South are proud to be from the South. And I'm going to kick your Yankee butt like your mama should have done a long time ago. Crybaby Chris, I wouldn't want to be you for all the tea in China. You got a lot of talent, but you got the worst attitude. You're the sneakiest, cheatingest little punk I've ever seen in my life. I'm going to make you famous right there in Knoxville, February 13th, Bloody Sunday.
Well, fans, there you see it. And coming up, it's Sunday Bloody Sunday. It's the War Between the States with Tracy Smothers and Chris Candido.
And I tell you what, talking about a war, coming up after this break, the Moondogs and the Bruise Brothers. Highlights, we'll see it right after this.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
We're back on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. You know, the Bruise Brothers were suspended 6 weeks ago for taking a fight with the Moondogs to the back of the arena. Well, their suspension is up, and it's Sunday Bloody Sunday. They face the Moondogs inside a steel cage. They won't be able to fight anywhere. They'll be heads up in that cage. Let's take a look at some highlights of the Bruise Brothers and the Moondogs.
I was a rebel from the day I left school. Grew my hair long and broke all the rules. I'd sit and listen to my records all day, with big ambitions of when I could play. My parents taught me what life was about, so I grew up the type they warned me about. They said my friends were just an unruly mob, and I should get a haircut and get a real job. Get a haircut and get a real job. Clean your act up. Get it together like your big brother Bob. Why don't you get a haircut, get a real job? I even tried that 9-to-5 scene. I told myself that it was all a bad dream. I found a band and some good songs to play. Now I party all night, I sleep all day. I met this chick, she was my number one fan. She took me home to meet her mommy and dad. They took one look at me and said, oh my God, get a haircut and get a real job.
You hear the whistle from Jim Cornette to start off our first match here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
I tell you, when they come in the studio, I want to leave. I'm ready to go.
Whoa!
Look at this big sign.
Oh, man.
I tell you, with chairs, with signs, with fats, with boards, with trash cans, it doesn't make any difference. Any and everything they can get their hand on. I still think these guys ought to put in straight jackets. I think they got an island off somewhere that they ought to be sent off to, Dutch.
You think what now?
It must be an isolated island somewhere with bars around the thing that they could send these guys to.
Well, they're from the swamps of Louisiana, and they got a race of Moondogs down there. A lot of people don't know this. You know, they have the Caucasian race, but they have the Moondog race too. And right see now, they got a stop sign in the ring and a road construction sign and a tear, and they're beating this boy half to death.
Hey, I want to get in on this microphone.
Is this the most dangerous tag team that you've ever seen?
They ought to have straight jackets.
They're Moondogs.
They ought to be in chains somewhere.
No, they ought to be in a cage, and that's what they're going to be. February 13th, Bruise Brothers, your suspension is up. You want to come back to Smoky Mountain Wrestling? Well, this is what you're going to have to face inside a steel cage. No way out. They're like animals.
They're like animals.
That's right. They are animals. They're Moondogs.
That's completely uncalled for. Just
and the
beating
Bruise
the guy
Brothers
to try to beat the guy to death.
Sunday, Bloody Sunday. And I'm going to get my final revenge on the Bruise Brothers.
Sunday, Bloody Sunday, fans.
I cannot.
February 13th in Knoxville.
Bob, I can't.
Fans, it's going to be the two wildest teams in wrestling inside the steel cage at Sunday, Bloody Sunday.
And speaking of wild, when we come back from this break, we're going to focus on the Heavenly Bodies and the Rock and Roll Express.
Fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming back to Paintsville, Kentucky with the Golden Week 94 tour at Johnson Central High School Friday, March the 11th at 8 p.m. The biggest card ever in Paintsville. We'll see you there. Everett's, Kentucky, North Everett's Elementary School, Thursday, March the 3rd, 7:30 p.m. And we're also coming to Red Jacket, West Virginia, the Red Jacket Grade School Gym, Friday, February the 18th. And we're coming back to Barberville, Kentucky at Knox Central High School on Friday, February the 25th at 8 p.m. with Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Terror. The Moondogs against the Bruise Brothers, and also for the tag titles, no time limit, no DQ in Barberville. Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies against the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, it seems like the Rock and Roll Express aren't too happy with what went on last time in Barberville, but then again, the Rock and Roll Express are never happy at what goes on when they get in the ring with the Heavenly Bodies. So this time, it's no time limit, no disqualification. They say that'll give them an advantage because they can fight fire with white fire, but what it actually means is that it's no time limit. That means it can go all night, and it's no disqualification. That means anything that we can think of that we want to do, we can do it and get away with it. You know what? So can they, but we're smarter than they are, and we know how to cheat better, and we can think of more things. Rock and roll, you asked for it to be this way. That means you're stupid, and Jim Cornette don't feel sorry for stupid people.
Barberville, Kentucky, Friday, February 25th, Knox Central High School. It's a grudge tag match. The Dirty White Boy and Tracy Smothers with the Dirty White Girl taking on Brian Lee, Chris Candido, and Tammy Fitch.
You know what? I was just thinking a little while ago, and last time we were in Barberville, I pinned her. I pinned the Dirty White Girl. Everybody saw I pinned her. One, two, three. And it was easy. She wanted her five minutes. Well, she got them. And then later on, I'm sure everybody saw this too, my boys beat the living duty out of the Dirty White Boy and Tracy Smothers, and now everybody said you're sore loser because everybody on that side got beat up. Well, now they want a tag match. Well, you're going to get one.
That's exactly right. Tag match. You know, they call them TNT. Tracy and Tony, y'all to be called B&B, Bumpkin and Bumpkin, boys, because when we get you in Barberville, it's going to be the worst town and the worst night you've ever been in.
Fans, welcome back to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We're talking about Sunday Bloody Sunday, and in fact, your Heavenly Bodies are doing double duty that day at Sunday Bloody Sunday. What about the furnaces?
Another example of the conspiracy against the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette, Doug and Mike Furness, the Tennessee-Alabama match. The rules are real simple. The University of Tennessee football helmet is sitting up on top of a 10-foot pole. Anybody that climbs that pole and gets it can use it any way they want. And Furness Brothers, if you lose, then you've got to stand there in the middle of the ring in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum and put on University of Alabama sweatshirts and proclaim them the greatest team in the history of college football, something that your volunteer buddies would kill you for. As a matter of fact, I understand the Furness Brothers have something to say. Let's go ahead and hear those two mush-mouthed dumb jocks.
Bub, take a look at this and tell me what it is.
Boy, that is the most disgusting thing I've ever seen. It looks like, you know, all the country people out there, it looks like what you use out there by the outhouse when you run out of corn cobs, and everybody knows what those are for. That looks like an Alabama cheerleader or Jim Cornette's backside. I can't remember. I just can't stand that. It's disgusting stuff. Oh, let's get on it worse than that.
You know, let me tell you something. February 13th, if you think for a minute that two players from University of Tennessee is going to wear this in the middle of the ring, there's no way.
It ain't going to happen. We're going after this thing right here, and we're going to do the right thing with it when we get there.
And that's knock some knots on some heads. And Cornette, you stick that little beanie head of yours through there, and I will put a major dent in it.
Well, fans, there you hear the comments from the Furness Brothers. Jim, they sound very confident about the match coming up with the Heavenly Bodies at Sunday Bloody Sunday.
Hey, the University of Tennessee Volunteers, they sound confident every year, and they never beat anybody. But let me tell you somebody else that sounds confident, the Rock and Roll Express. After the Heavenly Bodies beat up on the Furness Brothers, we got to do double duty, like you said, and wrestle a rock and roll. And it's a battle of family pride because Ricky Morton's so upset over what we did to his old bald-headed, fossilized father. Well, let me just explain something to you, Morton. It's time you realize that the Morton family is never going to top Jim Cornette or the Heavenly Bodies. As a matter of fact, my good friend Dutch Mantell put a little recap together of exactly what happened between us and Mr. Morton. Let's take a look at that right now.
With everything we have. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you to you, sir.
What is that, Doug?
Like Jane Dixon or something? I don't know what it is.
Hey, listen to this, Dutch. It says, Bob, don't tell Ricky, but his father Paul is here tonight. Paul has been in bad health, and Ricky couldn't go home for Christmas because we were wrestling, so they haven't seen each other in a long time. I flew Paul over here as a surprise to Ricky. He's in the extra locker room, and we're going to surprise Ricky later in the program. What about that, fans?
And Ricky doesn't know he's here. Of course, Ricky doesn't know a lot of things, but I'm certain. Wait a minute. We got company in the ring.
Wait a minute. We got, what is this? We got Bobby Blaze, and we got Gibson, and Morton, he leaves the ring.
Wait a minute. What
the heck
is
going on about this?
Wait a minute. He's running to the back. What is going on here? He's leaving the ring. Referee Mark Curtis, what is going on?
I don't know. I tell you, he's left. We had Mr. Morton, Paul Morton, back in a separate dressing room, and we was going to bring him into our dressing room after Ricky's match started, and he went through the bathroom, and evidently he ran into the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette, and there was some words exchanged. From what I can gather, I don't know, you know how obnoxious Cornette can be, and apparently Paul Morton slapped the taste out of Cornette's mouth. And he reached back and grabbed some drain cleaner or something. His stuff's all over the floor. And it hit him in the eyes, and he's in pretty bad shape. And right now, we really don't know what's taking place.
Then Cornette, boy, is he upset, is he irate. Said he didn't mean for that Drano to get in his eyes, and I'm sure he didn't. Watch out. Good heavens alive.
Well, wait a minute.
Here's Morton. Gibson came charging in. He's trying to get to the Heavenly Bodies. We got the Dirty White Boy, the Wild-Eyed Southern Boy, Bobby Blaze, three of them trying to hold Gibson back.
Well,
I have gone and I have gotten an injunction. My attorneys met with the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Board of Directors, and it's basically this. They can't be coming out here disrupting television, can't be disrupting interviews.
No.
I've got an injunction. If the Rock and Roll Express attack me, even lay one finger on me outside a sanctioned match, then they'll both be suspended indefinitely. Out of here. They won't get their revenge.
So what you're saying, if they touch you outside a sanctioned Smoky Mountain Wrestling match, they're out of here.
That's exactly. I couldn't do anything about what happens in the course of a match, but they can't disrupt any more of our interviews.
That's right.
They can't disrupt any more of my things that I do over there to set, and they can't attack me outside a sanctioned match between the Heavenly Bodies and the Rock and Roll Express. Now I want to say one more thing. I don't know why that Ricky Morton is so upset about his father nearly being blind in one eye or whatever's the matter with him. Because after all, I know Paul Morton. I've known him for a long time. The guy has been blind, staggering, falling down drunk for the past 25 years. He's got a drinking problem is what he's got.
Yeah.
He's a staggering, falling down drunk, and he's been blind for...
Wait a minute, guys. Wait a minute.
Go ahead and hit him! Hit him just one time, and then we'll be ready, Morton. Go ahead, touch him just one time. Hit him. Come on, big boy. Touch him.
Jim, I can't believe it. How can you do that to Ricky Morton and then laugh about it? It's his father, for God's sake.
Let me explain something to you and to Ricky Morton. I torment Ricky Morton because it's fun, because I love it, because I hate their filthy, stinking guts, and so do the Heavenly Bodies, and it's Sunday, bloody Sunday. The Bodies are going to put the Rock and Roll Express in their place once and for all, just like we did to his old man. And speaking of somebody else that needs to learn their place, it's the Bullet, and we're going to have Terry Funk coming up in just a few moments right after this break, a man who's going to put the Bullet in his proper place.
Fans, there's a lot more at stake in this match, more than just a wrestling match between the Bullet and Terry Funk. There's a lot more at stake.
Oh, yeah. There's humiliation. There's honor. There's pride at stake. There's a man's livelihood at stake. And let me just explain this. First of all, Smoky Mountain Wrestling did announce Golden Week 94. The kickoff is the March 10th Cobb Civic Center event called the Armstrong Family Reunion. But since it is a Smoky Mountain Wrestling event, if the Bullet loses, The match is Sunday, Bloody Sunday against Terry Funk, and he has to unmask, and it's Bob Armstrong, as everybody knows it is, and he leaves, then he can't be a part of his own family reunion, and that would be the greatest thing that ever happened to me. Not only would I unmask Bob Armstrong, get him out of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, not only would all the people in the Knoxville Coliseum see him kiss my feet, but then he'd have to leave his little kids all alone, he'd have to leave his family, and he wouldn't be able to take part in his big homecoming in Marietta, Georgia on March the 10th. So I want you now to take a look at a little piece of videotape sent in by the only man that the Bullet or Bob Armstrong, neither one, have ever beaten, Terry Funk.
This is my brother. If the world was left up to him, it would be much simpler. For you see, he knows how to handle the tough situations that arise in individuals' lives. For instance, if he found a stray cat that he didn't want, he would drown that cat. If he, or even I, found a mad dog, we would shoot that dog. If we came across a sick and helpless horse, we would put that horse down. And the same holds true when you find a fool that is disrupting your life. Like Bob Armstrong is disrupting Jim Cornette's life. Believe me, Tonya Harding's husband knew how to take care of the situation. It's just that he didn't go in there with the right ammunition. He sent a 350-pound bodyguard with a little baton to slap that lady on the legs. Do you realize if that would have been me that they hired, Nancy would never, ever, ever do a triple axel in the Olympics. Nancy would never, never, ever do a figure eight, nor a figure 7, 6, 5 or 4. Possibly she couldn't even do a figure one, and believe me, a one-legged monkey can dance that well. So what have you got to say about this, Armstrong? You had better think seriously what we are planning. We are planning it through Cornette, and what we are going to do is we are going to eliminate you from wrestling because of the Texas death match rules. Tell them, Junior.
Terry, a lot of these people might not know me, and a lot of these people might know me, but Bob Armstrong remembers me from a long time ago, and I'm coming to Knoxville. And when you step in that ring with my brother in a Texas death match, remember this: falls don't count. No stopping the match because of blood. The match continues until one man is left standing in the middle of the ring. My brother, Terry Funk here, king of the Texas death matches. He's the best. Armstrong, you're going down, and I'm going to be there to watch it.
Down, Armstrong, you and your illegitimate crew.
Fans, there you see it. Sunday, Bloody Sunday coming up. We've had a little disturbance here in the studio.
Okay. You know, for a fat dude, that Jim Cornette can run like a jackrabbit. Now, there's two sides to every story. We've heard his side. He's always making a big deal about, I've never beat Terry Funk. Well, if you'll take a look at some film, you'll understand why I never beat Terry Funk. I never really got the chances. This film is going to show you right now.
Can Armstrong hold on to that sleeper? Funk is down on, he was on one knee. Now he's sitting up. Here comes Dr. Tom Pritchard. Bob Armstrong broke the sleeper hold. Scott Armstrong and Tom Pritchard going at it outside, and Armstrong going to take care of business with Terry Funk. And he sends Funk down. Little red on Funk's forehead. Two count. Funk raised up. Tom Pritchard. And look here. Here comes one of the Bruise brothers. Armstrong's going to take care of him. Bruise brothers. Here comes. Ricky Morton's in the action now.
Ricky Morton and one of the Bruise Brothers, Scott Armstrong and Dr. Tom Pritchard. But in the ring, we've got Terry Funk and Bob Armstrong. And all heck is broken out here in the Knoxville Coliseum as Terry Funk taking plenty of punishment. There goes Dr. Tom Pritchard's head into the ring post. And Funk is down on his back. Bob Armstrong goes for the cover, too. Uh-oh, there's Jim Cornette interfering. Jimmy Del Rey and Brian Armstrong into it now. We've got the Armstrongs involved with the Heavenly Bodies and Terry Funk and Bob Armstrong inside the ring. And across the way, one of the Bruise Brothers and Ricky Morton. Well, we're bound to see it. Here comes the Bruise Brothers number two, and Bob Armstrong catches him. Meanwhile, Terry Funk is getting on his feet as Scott Armstrong and Dr. Tom Pritchard battle on the floor. Terry Funk missed Bob Armstrong and caught one of the Bruise Brothers. And once again, Terry Funk is on his back. Brian and Jimmy Del Rey, Scott Pritchard, and Scott Armstrong going at it. And across the way, the Steiners are double-teaming. Cornette got the boot and missed Bob Armstrong and caught Terry Funk. Now Bob Armstrong has the collar, the neck protector, and jerks it off of Jim Cornette. Bob Armstrong going right back to work on Cornette, but he's got away. Here comes that branding iron. Terry Funk has it between his legs. Here it comes. Looky here. And he catches Bob Armstrong on the back of the neck with that branding iron and drops it outside and rolls over on Bob Armstrong as the referee counts one, two. Did we get a three count? The winner, Terry Funk, it looks like. Let's see. Terry Funk was helped out.
Bullet, it seems like every time you turn around, they're always trying to stack the deck against you.
That's exactly right. You know, and I've been in some important matches in my career, but today, Sunday, Bloody Sunday, is the most important match in my career. If I don't beat Terry Funk in this Texas death match, which he's never lost one, not only do I have to unmask, Bob Armstrong will never be the commissioner of Smoky Mountain, and I won't get to attend the Armstrong family reunion in Marietta, Georgia. So it's all stacked. But I'll tell you this, Cornette. When the cards have all been dealt, who knows what will happen? I may come up aces, and you may be the joker of the bunch. And as far as kissing your feet, I'd rather kiss a rat's fanny over a hot fire than kiss your feet anywhere in the world, especially in front of my friends in Knoxville, Tennessee. So I've got my mind right. I've got my head right. And as far as never losing a Texas death match, you know, there's always a first time for everything. And I've never give up yet, and I'm not giving up hope. You people have supported me more than a man could ever expect. And today is the most important match for all of us. Together we can do it. And I'll tell you this, Mr. Funk. You may be T for Texas, but I'm T for Tennessee. And when it's over today, brother, after you and me, we'll finally decide if I'm really bad to the bone.
Fans, it's Sunday Bloody Sunday at the Knoxville Civic Coliseum. Coming up, we'll talk about the Dirty White Girl and Tammy Fitch. Now you can have the Bluegrass Brawl, Smoky Mountain Wrestling's wildest event ever on home video. Witness the three-team street fight, the Heavenly Bodies against the Stud Stable, against the Rock and Roll Express and Arn Anderson. Relive the magic of Tracy Smothers winning the Smoky Mountain Wrestling title. All matches complete and uncut. Send for a free merchandise brochure with tapes, shirts, caps, photos, and more. Write to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, P.O. Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, 37814. Order your merchandise today from Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Fans, welcome back to this special edition of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Before we address the situation between the Dirty White Girl and Tammy Fitch, Jim Cornette, he's back in the building, and he has this special report about the situation between the Dirty White Boy and Primetime Brian Lee.
Well, it's been a long-running saga, the feud between Dirty White Boy and Primetime Brian Lee, and it began innocently enough. Ron Wright had put a $20,000 bounty on the head of Tracy Smothers, payable to anybody that could knock Tracy out of professional wrestling, because Tracy was just driving Ron out of his mind. Well, Brian Lee took him up on the offer at a match on Fire on the Mountain, 93 in Johnson City, Tennessee. It was Brian Lee against Tracy Smothers, but as you can see here on your screen, Dirty White Boy is the one who did the damage to the leg. Now the time came for Ron to pay the bounty money off. Here's exactly what happened.
All right, you saw it. What happened at Fire on the Mountain 93? Mr. Wright, are you finally satisfied?
Let me tell you, I've never been so happy. I'm so happy, I just about lost my voice and can't talk. I took the last $25,000, got a cashier's check here, every dime I could borrow, beg, and steal, and cashed in my insurance policies to get this money together to get rid of Mr. Tracy Smothers. And I want to be proud to present this check to the man that took him in the match and got rid of it, Mr. Primetime Brian Lee. I've never been so happy. I'm taking triple heart medicine.
Oh, what are you talking about? I'm the man that put Tracy Smothers out. It wasn't him. I did it. What are you doing?
The match with him. He was the man that had the match in my heart.
I'm the man that put him out.
Hold up. It was my match.
Well, the Dirty White Boy felt like the money rightfully belonged to him, but Ron Wright stood firm in his decision until he found out that Tracy Smothers would be back in action in a couple of weeks. So what happened when they asked for the money back? Problems.
We want our money right now. We're tired of waiting around, and we're not going to wait any longer.
I told you before, the money's already spent. I mean, the money's as good as spent. Next time I face Tracy Smothers, I'm going to take him out once and for all. All you have to do is sit in a cage at ringside.
Set no cage.
Well, I'm not saying you want to sit in a cage. I wouldn't want to sit in a cage either. Just sit in the cage, and I'll take care of Tracy's mother's in the ring, and the money's all the way out.
Wait a minute. Let's see what Ronnie has to say. Ronnie, this is what we can do. I can give your money back this week, but then I won't be able to get that real nice dress that I saw on Rodeo Drive last week. Or we could wait another week and I can give you another neck rub and Brian can have another match with Tracy, and if Brian beats him and puts him out of wrestling, then everything will be fine. But if he doesn't, then I'll give you back your money. What do you think about that? Mwah.
Well, I think we could wait maybe one more week.
Well, from this point on, Tammy Fitch and Ron Wright became inseparable. Tammy was giving him his neck rubs and taking good care of him, and Ron, in turn, was buying Tammy presents. As a matter of fact, a lot of them. Well, the Dirty White Boy was beside himself because he couldn't get near Ron to talk to him. But things really heated up when it became obvious that not only was Tammy buying a lot of things with Ron's credit cards, but she was also administering his medicine now in a very special way. Take a look.
Let me ask Mr. Ron Wright. I want to know, Mr. Ron Wright, do you miss the Dirty White Boy?
You know, Bob, I was sitting here thinking about when me and my brother back many years ago, we won that Tennessee state title. I can't remember whether it was in Johnson City, Knoxville, Memphis, or somewhere, but you know, I've really had some fond memories in this wrestling life. We won them titles somewhere, and things has really been kind of out of focus, but winning them belts was some of the greatest highlights in my life, Bob. It's just something that it's hard for me to remember and get all straight when it was and how it happened, but it was something, I'll tell you. Yeah, and I'll tell you another thing, you know, back in my career, it spread such a long time. I won many titles, and I can't remember the dates and where I got them and stuff, but I'm telling you, seem like things get jumbled up and it's hard to kind of get everything straightened out, but due time I'll get it straightened out and get the date straight on it, and we'll try to get it worked out.
Well, I found out everything except whether or not he misses the Dirty White Boy. What about it?
I think I want to go home now. Let's go home.
Oh, wait a minute.
All right, you two, you listen up, and you listen up real good. Either one of you two hurt this man any way, shape, form, or fashion, and there's going to be hell to pay. You understand me, son?
Well, the following week, guess whose name was drawn to face Dirty White Boy in a Beat the Champ TV title match? Yeah, you guessed it, Brian Lee. And here's where things started getting really ugly.
Now Lee gets him with that loaded glove.
Wait Tammy a minute. Tammy Fitch just rolled right into
Ron
the ring.
Ron Wright is getting in the ring.
Something right into the
Ron
eye.
Ron Wright is getting up.
Hey, what in the world?
Wait a minute.
doing in
Wait
there?
Wait a minute. Oh,
he big right hand. Down goes right. A big right hand from Ron Wright to primetime Brian Lee. Now, and Lee came back with a right. Watch, I can't believe it.
Ron Wright is down.
What's Ron Wright doing in the ring?
He couldn't stand.
Look at primetime Brian Lee way up under the rope. Right down onto the knee of Ron Wright.
Right on the knee of Ron Wright. And he's hammering Dirty White Boy with a glove again. And Mr. Wright is out of it.
He's lying out helpless in the ring. And, hey, Lee's not finished. There's another one to the knee.
Well,
I can't believe he's doing it.
Well, with Ron Wright hospitalized for knee surgery, the Dirty White Boy was a man without a country. He didn't have any friends because, after all of his old friends sided with Lee, and all of his enemies didn't trust him, especially Tracy Smothers. Yeah, he was really a man without a country and a man without any friends, almost.
With a what? Person. Dirty what? White Boy hadn't got a friend in the world, Dutch. He's got nobody to help him.
Well, he has nobody to blame if he doesn't have any friends.
Well, hey. Let me tell you something. Like I've said it 100 times. I said it 100 times. He has dampened my spirits. He's hurt my chances. That man, you could write a book on what he's done to me. I'm awful sorry.
Look at this.
I'm awful sorry, fellas. I know he needs help, but doggone it, I just can't help him.
So
I don't care.
You're not going to help him?
No, Dutch.
Somebody needs to help him.
Hey.
He needs some help up there in the
room. With all due respect, they can kill each other for all I care.
Wait a minute.
I'm out of here.
We got a visitor. That's the Dirty White Girl. Wait a minute.
She just dives in it. Tammy Finch takes her down.
Okay, fans.
And
Tracy Smothers has just left the broadcast booth. He is going back to the dressing room. Wait a minute. I think Brian Lee doesn't know how to handle this Dirty White Girl. He's like trying to get a cat off his face.
Well, with the Dirty White Girl on the scene, the odds were even, but Tammy Fitch still escaped retribution at every turn and even added some fuel to the fire.
Wait a minute. They're going down to the ring in primetime Brian Lee. What did he... Well, he had something he sprayed right in the eyes of the Dirty White Boy. Now they've got the Dirty White Girl. Look at Lee's trying to hold her. What's Tammy Fitch going to do?
Uh-oh.
She's got some makeup.
Oh, she's putting some
lipstick or something all
she's
over her
showing
face.
Some first-hand experience on Tammy's tips. She is giving her a lesson on how to apply makeup.
She's applying it all over her face, Dutch.
Oh.
Well, the Dirty White Boy finally got the match that he wanted, a Tennessee chain match at Sunday Bloody Sunday for the heavyweight title against primetime Brian Lee, and Ron Wright will return to be in the Dirty White Boy's corner. But that's not all, because White Boy gave Brian Lee a little taste, a preview of what was to come at Sunday Bloody Sunday with the Tennessee chain.
He's got Killer Kyle's violin case to the back of the Dirty White Boy.
Now it's 3-1. It looks like the Dirty White Girl, I can't see her anywhere.
I think she's on the far. She was on the apron. I think she may be down on the floor now.
Yeah. Okay, Brian Lee up on the outside.
There she is, still on the apron. Here's Lee now up on that top rope, Dutch.
They got White Boy stretched out. Wait a minute.
Tracy Smothers.
Here he comes. Oh!
Smothers now going to get hit from behind.
Now here comes Kyle and Candido trying to take out Tracy Smothers.
The White Boy's gone to the corner, Dutch. Watch out. He's got that chain. He's going to clear house now.
And everybody's getting out of the ring. Wait a minute. There's one man left.
Brian Lee.
He's got Lee.
He's got it around
his neck. He's got him hung. He's got it around his neck. And over the top, and he's got him hung.
He's got him hung over on the rope, Dutch.
And it's pure panic. They're trying to get him loose.
White Boy and Tracy Smothers, they're trying to keep him from getting him loose. They finally got him loose.
Well, nobody knows the Tennessee chain match better than the king of them, Ron Wright. And right now, let's go to these comments Ron Wright made from his home in beautiful East Tennessee.
Let me tell you people something. I've never been so mad, disgusted in my life as what's went on here in the last few weeks since I've been in the hospital having hip implant surgery. Let me tell you something, prime time. You finally made the mistake of your life with your manager, the little Miss Prissy Know-It-All, Miss Fitch. You made the terrible mistake of putting your name on the dotted line to get in the ring with the Dirty White Boy in one of these Tennessee bloody chain matches. Let me tell you, I'm the master of them. I invented them, and I beat every man from from A to Z in these things. Come February the 13th in Knoxville, Tennessee, prime time, I've got your name stamped on this oak walking cane, son. When I get done with you, I'm going to get the last lick with this. After the dirty white boy has done got you beat half to death, laying in the ring unconscious, when they bring you out on stretchers, I'm going to wrap this walking stick around your head like nothing's never been wrapped around your head before in your life. And misfit, you'll probably get your head smacked plumb off your shoulder, and I'll lay you on the stretchers with him and laugh when they carry both of you out of there.
Fans, don't go away, because when we come back, the latest incident leading up to Sunday Bloody Sunday, Dirty White Girl gets a match with Tammy Fitch. We'll be right back.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Well, fans, now that you know the history, let's see the match between the Dirty White Boy and Primetime Brian Lee from Barberville, Kentucky.
And Dirty White Girl finally gets her shot at Tammy Fitch, but this is in a way that nobody expected.
And fans, here we are in Barberville, Kentucky at Knox Central High School. Primetime Brian Lee against the Dirty White Boy. The stipulations are, if Dirty White Boy wins, the Dirty White Girl gets 5 minutes alone with Tammy Fitch in the ring in a match. Dirty White Boy reeling now. Primetime Brian Lee shoots him in. Dirty White Boy ducks the clothesline. A big clothesline from the Dirty White Boy. Primetime Brian Lee goes down. He's reeling from that clothesline from the man from Bucks North, Tennessee. He comes back up. Dirty White Boy gives him two big boots. Another boot into the midsection. Another right and another left. He backs Brian Lee into the corner. He has Brian Lee reeling now. Big right hand from Dirty White Boy right onto the chin of Primetime Brian Lee as he's taking out his frustrations now. He drags him out into the middle of the ring, takes him. He's shooting him in. Dirty White Boy in. Brian Lee comes off with a big leg drop. Brian Lee is all shook up. No, there you see it. Tammy Fitch handed him the hairspray. The Dirty White Boy has been sprayed with the hairspray. Kentucky, but there comes the White Girl. She's trying to get the hairspray out of the hand of Brian Lee. Brian Lee pushes her back. It looks like he hit her under the chin. I don't know if he meant to do it or not, but he's knocked the Dirty White Girl completely unconscious in the middle of the ring. Fans, I don't believe that Tammy Fitch has the gall to say that the match will start right now. The Dirty White Girl has been knocked literally unconscious from Brian Lee, and she's got the nerve to do this. She's going down for the pin. Referee Mark Curtis, you can tell he doesn't want to have to make the three count, but he has no choice in the matter. There he comes with the three count. Tammy Fitch wins this match. This is the most disgusting thing Tammy Fitch has done so far.
Sunday, Bloody Sunday. You know, I'm not concerned with anything. You know, the White Girl, she wanted to be in the match. I asked her to step down. She'll get her chance to get even. But I'm not worried about Miss Tammy Fitch. I'm not worried about nothing. Everything that I'm concerned about is one man, and it's going straight ahead. Primetime Brian Lee. A 12-foot chain strapped to my left wrist, strapped to your left wrist. The only way to win this match is to touch all four corners. And to do that, you got to have your opponent flat of his back. Primetime Brian Lee, Sunday Bloody Sunday. Come taste the blood. I know I'm gonna bleed. You can look at this big ugly head. I've been in a lot of fights. But you're gonna bleed first. You're going to bleed last, and you're going to bleed the longest. I'm walking out the champ, like it or not.
Oh, Brian, will you just quit your whining? I don't know how we got into this, but you're just going to have to go in there, and you're just going to have to win. There's nothing I can do about it.
Tammy, there's a difference between whining. I'm not whining. You're my manager. I'm a wrestler. How did I even get into this? Oh. You're the manager. Managers set up their matches. I'm the wrestler. I slam the wrestlers, okay?
Oh, yeah. Well, Brian, if you don't think you're man enough...
Oh, man, now we go... Why do we have to go to this macho thing? You always bring the man thing up. You know I'm a man. I keep... Just a second. Well, Dirty White Boy, I'll tell you what. You don't worry about the problems that we're having because your problem is 6'8", 280 pounds, and I'm going to find one way to take you out, the 13th. 13th's the unlucky number. 13th's going to be your unlucky day. Sunday, Bloody Sunday, I'm going down to the mat with you. 1, 2, 3.
Brian, I don't care what you do. I don't care how much you bleed. Just don't get it on my clothes. I don't care what you have to do. Just don't lose that title, because if you lose that title, I will never speak to you again.
Woo-hoo, brother, a Tennessee chain match for the Smoky Mountain heavyweight title. The Dirty White Boy against Primetime Brian Lee. Tammy Fitch in Brian Lee's corner. Ron Wright in Dirty White Boy's corner. And where will Dirty White Girl be in all this? Nobody knows, but we'll find out today at Sunday Bloody Sunday. And we'll be right back.
Wrestling fans in Kentucky, Smoky Mountain Wrestling coming back to Paintsville, Johnson Central High School, Friday, March the 11th at 8 p.m. with Golden Week 94, the biggest card ever in Paintsville. Everts, Kentucky at the North Everts Elementary School, Thursday, March the 3rd at 7:30 p.m. Red Jacket, West Virginia Grade School Gym, Friday, February the 18th at 8 p.m. And Barberville, Kentucky, Knox Central High School, Friday, February 25th at 8 o'clock, Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Terror, the Moondogs against the Bruise Brothers, and for the tag titles, no time limit, no DQ, the Rock and Roll Express against the Heavenly Bodies.
That's right. You know, the last time that we were in Barberville, Jimmy Cornette, you slicked us again. But you see, the Rock and Roll Express, we can accept the losses right with the wins. But you see, this time it's no time limit, no disqualification. Anything goes. Anything that you're thinking about doing, we're going to do it. You see, all the fans are going to see a new side of the Rock and Roll Express, because we're going to start living by the law of the jungle instead of the law of the land. Remember, it's an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. We'll see you, Jimmy Cornette. Bring your heavenly bodies, because we're coming after those titles, buddy.
Friday, February 25th, Barberville, Knox Central High School. It's a grudge tag match. The Dirty White Boy and Tracy Smothers with the Dirty White Girl in their corner against Brian Lee and Chris Candido, and they'll have Tammy Fitch in their corner.
You know what I'm getting real sick of, White Boy? Every time we got something going our way, there's some kind of interference. Everybody saw what happened in the Battle Royal last time. Well, we're going to hook it all up together right there in Barberville, a tag match. We're going to kick your butts like your mama should have done a long time ago, because none of you have no respect for this sport or the people in it. We're going to settle the score in Barberville. Tell them, Tony.
Primetime Brian Lee, the last time we were in Barberville, you humiliated my old lady. But then, even worse than that, you put your damn hands on her. You knocked her cold in a wedge. Well, by God, I'm not going to put up with it. And you had that little sleazy tramp come up and pin her for the three count. Well, that's not going to happen. What about that tramp?
As far as you go, you little streetwalker, you stick your nose in my business and I'll slap you in the next area.
Brian Lee, you're a dead man.
See ya.
Well, fans, we hope that you have enjoyed this special edition of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. It's going to be a great card in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum. It's Sunday, Bloody Sunday.
And whether you want to see a Tennessee chain match with the Dirty White Boy against Brian Lee, whether you want to see Ron Wright walk to the ring in the Knoxville Civic Coliseum, maybe you want to see the Moondogs and the Bruise Brothers locked up inside a steel cage, maybe you want to see the Heavenly Bodies beat up a couple of dumb jocks like the Furnace Brothers, or maybe you want to see the Heavenly Bodies beat up a couple of washed up, frustrated rock and roll singers like Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson. Maybe you want to see the War Between the States with Tracy Smothers against Chris Candido. But I'll tell you what I want to see. It all comes down to the Texas Death Match. Everything's riding on it. The Bullet, who everybody knows is Bob Armstrong, and the turbulent Texan himself, Terry Funk. Texas Death Match rules, which simply state that the match is going to go until somebody's hurt so bad they can't go on. And Bullet Bob Armstrong, if you lose, then you not only take that mask off and show everybody your face, but you have to leave Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Before you do that, you got to get down on your hands and your stinking knees, brother, and you got to crawl every agonizing, degrading, humiliating step of the way across the ring in that Knoxville Civic Coliseum. Purse your lips up and kiss Jim Cornette's feet. The ultimate humiliation. I know I can beat you black and blue. I can pay any number of people to come in here and drop you on your head and put you in the hospital time after time, and it still won't work. I can't get rid of you that way because you're just too proud. So what do you do to a proud man? You hit him in his pride. You stick that knife in and you tear those guts out. You humiliate him in front of his friends, his fans, and his family. And that's exactly what I'm going to do to you. Because if you have to get down on your hands and knees and kiss my feet in Knoxville, Tennessee, you'll never show your face again. And that's what I'm banking on. And I'm paying Terry Funk a lot of money to see that that happens. Sunday, Bloody Sunday, the Knoxville Civic Coliseum. Sunday afternoon, February 13th, today for you people in Knoxville is going to be a day that Bob Armstrong will never forget, but it's going to be a day that he'll regret until the end of time.